And the first pitch of the ball game here is taken for a called strike one. EK, you take a look at this Diamondback ball club as they begin play here tonight. They've been on the skids recently, losers in seven of their last nine ball games.
I just think they were sort of flat in the opener. They didn't play with a whole lot of inspiration, and that was reflected in the final score.
Throw on to first in time, one away. A chance now for the Los Angeles Dodgers starting lineup. Eric, who should we keep an eye on?
Well, I know these guys love what Justin Turner brings to their offense. He's been a one-man wrecking crew lately, driving in 20 runs over the last 10 ball games. I guess I shouldn't say one-man wrecking crew. It takes a lot of support from the guys above him to get in the position to be driven in, but he has been the man.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. Throw gets him, two down. And with a quick breather here, let's bring in a look at the defensive alignment for the Diamondbacks. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, remember, this manager has not jumped on board with all the defensive shifts. Still have that old-school mentality, plays guys straight up, so we'll see how that impacts this game.
Adrian Gonzalez will get his first opportunity here, currently leading the league in two of the three Triple Crown categories.
He's having just a great season, but it's so hard to lead all three categories. He's not even in the top five in average.
First offering on its way. Shot towards second. Well, this will be pulled in out there at second base, and that'll be that. Dodgers retired on just four pitches. Dodgers nothing, Diamondbacks coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Clayton Kershaw will be on the bump for game two of the series. Eric, any thoughts?
Yeah, Matty, in his last start, he had a ton of strikeouts. He'll be looking to duplicate that effort here.
Gene Segura comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half
leading
of the first.
For the Diamondbacks, the shortstop, Gene Segura.
To first, Gonzalez is up with it. He'll take it to the bag himself, and the leadoff man is gone here to start the home first. With that, let's take a look at the hometown Diamondbacks lineup card. EK, any thoughts?
Well, you've really got to appreciate the incredible talent of Paul Goldschmidt. He comes into this one as Mr. Clutch in this lineup, carrying a batting average with runners in scoring position over 350. That's pretty reliable, so he could definitely be an impact player in this game.
Chopped weakly to the left. Throw on to first will take care of him, and Kershaw is in control now, two away. With a moment now, let's look at how the Dodgers align on defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, they know their man on the hill has more strikeouts than anybody in the National League. Sometimes that can make you a little bit lazy out in the field. You just start watching swings and misses. You've always got to be on your toes, though, because the ball will be put in play, and you're going to have to be ready for it.
Paul Goldschmidt is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Eric, you look at your former employers, the Dodgers, as they enter play here tonight. All you can really say is they've been on one heck of a run.
And the even better news for them is that they've got their ace going here tonight. So you have to figure that all signs are pointing toward another victory here.
Swing and a miss as it's dropped behind the plate. Victorino has it.
A.J. Pollock.
We'll dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. Kershaw comes set. Here comes the first pitch. In there, strike one. Well, you figure that curveball is going to be an important pitch for him going forward.
Yeah, I think it might even tell the story of how well he fares here tonight, because he's going to need to mix his speeds against a lineup like this. And once they start sitting on pitches, it could be trouble.
Throws him for strike three, and that retires the side. One left for the Diamondbacks. After one, no score. Corey Seager will stand in. He, too, had three hits in the win last night.
Well, you know, he's been averaging at least an RBI per game over his last 10, so yesterday's performance shouldn't have come as any big surprise to anybody.
And that's in there for strike one. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2.
And this is what you like to see, especially coming off of a loss in his last start. These first couple innings, he's coming right after guys.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
Well, anytime you're leading off an inning, it's true. You don't want to just go up there blindly swinging at anything close to the zone. But you also want to at least take the bat off your shoulder. I mean, he phoned this one in.
First pitch on its way. This is line to left. A screaming base hit here, his first of the night. So it's a one-out base knock for him here in the second. Good time to check out the league leaders in hits.
Well, it's just business as usual for him, Matt. He leads the National League in that category. And he's just been punishing mistakes at the plate. Been impressive to watch him swing the bat so far this year. He's got another nice game on his hands in this one.
Hard hit towards center. And that's into the outfield for a one-out hit. And he is in there. And you see on the graphic right there that his hitting streak will indeed live on as he just continues to hit the ball well.
Can you imagine waking up every morning, coming to the ballpark, knowing that you're going to get a base hit like he's feeling it right now?
Shane Victorino digs in as one of the more dangerous hitters in baseball right now as he's got a 10-game hitting streak to his credit. High fly ball out to straightaway center. On the move is Pollock. He's got it, and there are two down now. And boy, not quite sure why, but they decide not to risk it with two outs on a very deep fly ball. Really surprising.
This seems like an awfully big mistake to make out there. It's going to cost him a run. I can't think of a reason why he's not tagging up there. No excuse for it.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. Pollock has it in his tracks, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Dodgers strand a couple. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. Paul Covington will come forward now, back in the lineup after being used as a pinch hitter last night.
Paul Covington.
Into the seats, 0-1. Kershaw's ready. Here it is on 0-1. Belted high in the air out to left. Utley looking up. And this one is gone. A home run. And how about that? Paul Covington has got himself his first big league round tripper. We'll have to wait and see how many more of these he can mount in his career, but for now, oh, and while we talk, that pitch got away and ended up hitting him, so he'll head down to first on the hit by pitch. Phil Gosselin is next as he finds himself behind 0-1.
That's what you need to do after a hit by pitch. Get right back on that horse and fire a fastball in there.
Got him.
As we check the sequence again, here's how you conserve some pitches out there. Start off with a fastball for strike one, get ahead in the count. Then, nasty slider for strike two. Then he finishes the job with a nice overhand curveball, wasted no time, that's all she wrote.
Stepping in now, Oscar Hernandez, as Kershaw will get the upper hand here with strike one. Getting on base, a big problem as you see the average there. One home run, 10 RBIs. Now a chopper to first, might only get one. Gonzalez has got it. One there, on to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. Striding into the box, Patrick Corbin. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Carl Crawford is into the ballgame here as he takes over behind the plate.
Now catching, number three.
And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. And he misses with it, 1-1. A runner on first with two away. Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. Back with more here on a Tuesday night after this. Clayton Kershaw set to lead off the third, 9-1-2 due up.
Well, you know it's always a tough inning when your pitcher leads off for you because most of the time the guys just flat out can't hit. But who knows? Maybe he can get something started here and help himself out.
Into the windup and the pitch. High and deep to right center field. Back goes Pollock, but he won't have a play. This is down and into the gap. And he will make it into second with a two-base hit here to begin the third.
Oh, my goodness. This guy is really starting to heat up now. That's eight straight games with a base hit. He's been fun to watch.
Howie Kendrick will get an opportunity now following the leadoff double.
And with his guys down by a run, at the very least, you need to try to shoot something to the right side. Hopefully get that runner over to third with one out.
He's set. Here it comes. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. And that'll get down out there near the wall.
The right fielder, number 66, Yasiel Puig.
So striding in, Yasiel Puig, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Here's the first pitch to him. Catch made in left. Here comes the runner for the plate. In to score from third is the tying run. It's 1-1, and he's safe.
Yeah, I don't know. I wasn't sure they were going to send him on that ball. This was hit awfully hard, but they decided to roll the dice and take a chance to score him, and it's going to wind up paying off.
Adrian Gonzalez gets a shot here as he'll look to pick up the second run of the inning now from third base.
And you know, he doesn't really have to do that much right here. With one out, there's a ton of different ways for him to drive that guy in.
Hit hard towards center. In there, base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third. And the streak will continue as he creeps even higher up the all-time list.
Well, you feel so good at the plate, but now there's so much pressure on you to continue to get those base hits. We'll see how long you can keep doing it.
Here's Corey Seager. Hard liner toward short. In there, a base hit.
Well, there you go. 14 straight games now, and he hasn't gone hitless in a game in over 2 weeks. Do the math.
Into the box now, Justin Turner. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases.
Around third and being waved on home.
And the runner from second is in to score. It's now 3-1.
Throws there and he is meat at home plate.
Center fielder number 27, Charlie Blackman.
Walks into the box, reached base with a double his first time up.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up right here.
Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Hit hard toward second, and that's through into center field, base hit. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third, and it's a 4-1 game.
Batting seven, the catcher, number three.
That is now 8 hits he's already allowed, and we haven't even made it out of the third inning yet. As I heard someone once say, he's coming apart like a $39 suit out there. You better find his command, and fast.
Carl Crawford will stand in now, and his batting average currently good for 7th in the National League.
And he's right up there among the RBI leaders, too, so he's dangerous with runners on base.
First pitch coming, here it is. Lifted in the air out to center field. Pollock on the run. He's got it, a great running play, and that'll retire the side. So they nearly bat around here as 8 men come to the plate and they push across 4 runs. We'll head now to the home half of inning number 3. It's the Dodgers 4 and the D-backs 1. Gene Segura digs into the box in the bottom of inning number 3.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man. Spin the table for a little bit of a rally.
Kershaw into the windup. First pitch on its way. Chop foul at the plate. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. And there's ball one.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now, and that's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving it up there like that.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting toward the third base dugout and taken in out there for the first out.
Now after the four-run inning, we'll get to see if he approaches things any differently now that he's working with the league. You know, you figure the approach will be similar, but that's a good job anyway of getting the first out here.
Into the box now, Yosmani Tomas. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. First delivery to him on the way. Foul tip into the catcher's glove at strike one.
And if you're going to go after that pitch, you got to be thinking right field. I think he just pulled off of that one a little.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
And this battery knows full well that this guy's been scuffling lately. So they're not messing around here. They're coming right after him.
Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Tomas is retired, two down now. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season.
Well, guys, he's one of the best in the league in that department right now. Every time he takes a hill, this ball club has a great chance to walk away with a W. We'll see if he can wrap up another one for him here in this one.
Here comes the first pitch. High in the air out to center field. Blackman is under it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Diamondbacks down in order. They trail it 4-1. Chase Utley will come in now to lead things off against our starter, who probably wishes he had a mulligan to use on that last inning.
Yeah, he was doing just fine up until the last time he took the mound. He's got to hope that that was just an aberration, or he might not stick around to see another inning.
This is pulled into right, but this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first out.
And that's one of those plays where you might need to reinforce the laces on your glove after this inning ends. This is a fastball, and it is hammered. I mean smoked. But he ends up with nothing, and his average is going to go down.
Standing in now, Clayton Kershaw. As he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle, it's 0-1. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. 4-1 our score as we play inning number four. This is skied into short left center. Covington is calling for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Second, he's finding the terrain much easier to navigate this time around. After that four-run inning, this is a guy who needs a quick inning here, and he's two-thirds of the way home.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Howie Kendrick. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
And remember, he jumped all over that first pitch, so don't be surprised if he does it here again.
Line towards center field. Pollock is there, and they breeze through this half inning as the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Leading off the inning, A.J. Pollock, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
Kershaw looks in. Here's the first pitch. That's yanked into the stands. Strike one. Called strike two with the letters. 0-2 now.
And I'll tell you, being in a two-strike hole is not the spot you want to be in against a guy like this.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Well, he's had a lot of guys swinging at pitches out of the strike zone early on, so it's a great idea to go ahead and bounce one there on 0-2.
Our next telecast comes your way tomorrow afternoon in high definition as these two teams wrap up this three-game set. And you get a look there at the expected starters for tomorrow's contest. Digging in, Paul Covington. He went deep in his first at-bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here.
I can't imagine they're going to give him anything to hit this time around.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing and a miss, but he's right on here. One strike. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. And a diving effort there at third. Good way to bruise your ribs. How much for one of them ribs? It's a foul ball. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Well, you know, when you're behind in a count like this, it's all about changing your approach at the plate. You got to shorten up a little bit and just look to put the ball in play.
Oh, and look out as this runs in and gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one. First pitch of the at-bat. Jake Lamb stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. 0-1, here's the pitch. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Slider is in there, and now it's 1-2. One run, just one hit. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. To two balls and two strikes now. And he looks at a sinker for a called third strike, and now there are two gone.
Not only has he rung up a lot of strikeouts, but he still hasn't walked a batter to this point, so his control has been really, really spot on so far.
Into the box, Phil Gosselin. As Kershaw will get the upper hand here with strike one.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller out there, you're just conditioned to always look for something down. So he can surprise you with that high fastball, maybe four-seam it every once in a while. And when he does, you can forget it.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. One left for Arizona, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Yasiel Puig will stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball. A
couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And this is lined hard to deep left. And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth.
First pitch swinging here to start the inning, and he didn't waste any time waiting for his pitch. He got it right there. Just hit it right at somebody.
Here's Adrian now. as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
Well, you see his pitch count on your screen right there. That's not a mistake. He's been loving those first pitch outs, that's for sure.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. And this is into the alley for Adrian. Should be extra bases. And he'll cruise into the bag at second with a one-out double.
So with that knock right there, he's closing in on 2,000 hits in his career. Not a bad number to be chasing, wouldn't you say, Steve?
Well, it's a great number to be chasing, Eric. It's easy to focus on the bigger number like 3,000, but you can't get there without getting past 2,000 first. And it's been a fine career so far, and he's not done yet.
Here's Corey Seager. Hits it high and deep out to center field. Pollock going back on it. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. The relay throw, the tag at third, and they got him. A double play, and very quickly here, the side is retired. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Dodgers 4 and the D-backs 1. Oscar Hernandez comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Here's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
Good late break to the slider. 87 on the gun there. It's 1-2. He's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Pitcher number 46.
Ready now, Patrick Corbin. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Sinker to open the AB in there for strike one. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. That's right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
Throw on to Gonzalez, and that's out number two. So yet another strong outing for him tonight as we show you the league leaders in ERA.
Yeah, and you can find him one spot off the top. Second in the National League right now. And when you're pitching as well as he is, the scoreless innings just seem to stack up. He's got another good outing going here.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Kershaw is there for it. And the inning is over. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. They trail it 4-1. Justin Turner will start things out for the Dodgers in their half of inning number 6.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Here it comes. Hard liner to center field, and that'll get down for a base hit. So he goes after the first pitch, and it's early trouble here this half of the inning.
And now another base runner for him to contend with now. And as we bring up his line, you can see that's an even 10 hits against him so far. And you have to wonder how much longer they're going to let him stay out there.
Daniel Hudson will take over on the mound now here in the sixth inning. Right side, hit hard. Segura for one. On to first, but not in time as he beats it out.
This is always a tough throw here for a first baseman coming off the bag. You got to make sure that you don't just throw the ball right into the runner's back heading down to second base. Here he takes just a little extra time to make sure that he makes a good throw. And they're going to settle for just one at second.
Here's Carl Crawford now as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
shot toward right center. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
Now batting, left fielder, Chase Utley.
Chase Utley will stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball.
Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Tomas ranging back, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall.
Around third and being waved on home.
And the run will score all the way from first. Make it 5-1. And he is in there with an RBI triple.
Well, that hit extends his streak to lucky number 13 now. That's almost two full weeks where he's been swinging it.
Clayton Kershaw will get a shot now in an RBI spot, so a chance to help his own cause here.
And he's got a hit in the game already, so he can handle the bat at least a little bit.
Hit hard back up the middle, and that's through into center field. Base hit, and the runner from third crosses the plate. It's 6-1.
Helping his own cause right there, and no need to wait for the RBI guys to drive him in. He says, you know what, I can be an RBI guy too. That's a great at bat right there, and that drives in a run.
Howie Kendrick steps in to try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single.
And that's a nice job right there to drive in the run by the last guy. And it can definitely fire up a team when someone comes through big time with two outs.
Slapped hard the opposite way. And that'll get down for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
And at this point, I don't think you could expect anything less than a two-hit ball game from this guy. I mean, he's been as hot as anybody lately, and he comes through again here.
Yasiel Puig steps into the box, and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far.
Well, this could be a huge inning or maybe the end of the inning. This is a pivotal at-bat in one of the turning points of this ballgame right here.
And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. Seems like they're showing a lot of faith in this guy, leaving him. Hit hard, and oh, this is off the second base bag. And that's through into center field. Base hit. The throw home. Throws there, and he is out on a beautiful throw as he just came up firing that time.
Posed.
So two runs on five hits, no errors, and two left. 2, 3, and 4 due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Dodgers six, And the D-backs won. Yosmani Tomas will come in now to start things out here in their half of the sixth as they look for a reversal of fortunes here. The first five innings have not been particularly kind to them.
Yeah, and I think that's putting it mildly. Just one hit in these first five innings, they're going to need to do a better job of finding good pitches to hit. But that fellow on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
Outside for a ball, 1-1.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just watch it all the way in.
Slider, and look out, that's up in the danger zone.
Well, this is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count, and that alone can be beneficial to an offense.
Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was the solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
Paul Goldschmidt will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out 0 for 2 thus far. Kershaw gets the sign. Here's the first pitch. Grounded back up the middle. And that gets through for a one out base hit.
And you had to figure that sooner or later someone was going to do something at the plate. Well, that's just their second hit of the ball game. And it comes all the way in inning number 6. Offense has been almost non-existent so far.
A.J. Pollock will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far.
Well, we've been talking about it a lot, but this offense is just getting shut down right now. And we've seen some really fantastic pitching in this one.
From the stretch, he'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one. Swing and a miss. Looked like the slider there, a ball and a strike.
Yeah, that slider's been real good to him all night long. No reason not to ride that as much as he can.
Trying to strike him out for the third time. 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
And that's the right spot for that slider. Really try hard to tie him up inside. And that's a good job to lay off, too.
And he is down on strikes again. So get your hats out. That's the third strikeout of the game.
And all through this winning streak of theirs, we've seen some great starting pitching, and this has been another very good performance. Good enough to most likely keep that winning streak going.
Paul Covington will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike. Taken. Now it's 0-2. One run, two hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Randall Delgado is on the pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven. Adrian Gonzalez ready for another at-bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far.
Yeah, and you can bet he'd love to get himself that third hit. Those are the kind of games that puts a little extra pep in your step.
Pollock going back on it, but he can't get it as it's off the wall. And he is in the second with a double, his third hit of the night. So chalk up one more hit for him, giving him 1,999 for his career. That's a lot of hits, fellas.
Well, it certainly is a lot of hits, Matt, and he's been a fixture for years now, and those hits have been piling up like ants on the barbecue sauce out in my backyard.
And that's through into center field, base hit, and they'll put the brakes on at third. Runners at the corners with nobody out.
Now batting, third baseman.
Digging in, Justin Turner. He's looking to go 4-for-4 with a base hit right here. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Drilled to the left side. And there's a base hit as that gets through into left. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. It's now 7-1.
Now batting, the center fielder.
Charlie Blackman stands in. He'll try to improve in this at-bat after grounding into a fielder's choice his last time up. He pulls this one into right. Tomas is there, one away. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. One gone now in the LA seventh, and here comes the speedy Carl Crawford. He's set, and the pitch. Well, this is hauled in by the second baseman.
Now batting.
Chase Utley gets a shot now with two men on and two away here in inning number seven.
And we'll see here if he can come through. It can be discouraging to see opportunities like this late in a ball game go untapped.
But this won't get over the second baseman's glove as he's got it. Leading off the inning, Jake Lamb. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Boy, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
And he misses low with it, 2-0.
Now we've got a six-run lead out there, and there's no reason not to come right at guys.
Not a very undisciplined swing there. It's 2-1. In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch, but you got to do it. You can't give up that inside corner, or this guy will eat you alive.
Got him. As he just continues to mow down these hitters, 13 strikeouts now.
Phil
Gosselin is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one. Yet again, another first pitch strike.
One ball, one strike.
And it's a big reason of why he's having the success he is. You establish the count in your favor right away, and it just opens up the door to so many more options going forward.
That's going to even up the count at 2-2. Kershaw has been strong thus far. Just one run through 6 1/3. And here's a ball hit in the air. On the move is Puig. He makes the play. Really had to hustle to get to that one. Two gone now. So he's just a third of an inning away from putting up another zero as we take a look at the ball clubs with the lowest team ERAs.
Well, it's business as usual for them. They lead the National League in that department. And it's always nice to know that whoever steps on the bump for you, you're going to have a chance to win. A lot of teams are envious of that stat, and these pitchers, they deserve a lot of credit for what they've accomplished so far.
Trying to strike him out for the second time. Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2. Very weakly on the ground. That goes foul, so he stays alive with two strikes. Two out, nobody on. In tight with the slider, 2-2.
2-2.
Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Diamondbacks down in order. They're down 7. Clayton Kershaw steps in for a fourth plate appearance tonight, and why not? He's been in control all game.
Yeah, he's been in total control of this game, Matt. I see no reason to be going with anybody else out there on the mound right now.
Shot. shot back up the middle. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Boy, he's doing it all out there so far. Not only is he pitching a great game, but he gets in on the act offensively as well.
Fly ball heading for the alley. Covington giving chase, but he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning. And he is in there.
Well, these guys have been very aggressive on the fastball so far, and this is another example of it right here. You know, working the count is great and all, but if the guy's going to lay a fastball in there on the first pitch, no reason not to go after it. And he jumps all over this one.
A dive, but he can't get it. It's through into the outfield. And the run is in to score from third.
Well, if you want to point fingers at who's to blame for this disaster, you're going to need both hands. In the pitching, the batting, the defense, the execution. Just draw a line through this one. This one's been an absolute disaster.
Tyler Clippard will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Catch is made. Runner tagging from third. And to score is the runner from third. It's a 9-1 ball game.
Maybe not the most convincing start to his appearance right here, but he gets that first out anyway. And you'll see this ball's hit right on the screws. But hey, better to give up a line drive out than a seeing eye single.
Here's Corey Seager. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit. Standing in a perfect 4-for-4 so far, Justin Turner. And we'll see if he can put together a rare five-hit performance here. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And that's in there. Base hit. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away. Charlie Blackmon comes to the plate with ducks on the pond, as they say, looking to add to his team's already sizable lead.
What's that old saying, guys? The rich get richer? Well, his team's definitely been getting rich here all day.
Tomas racing back. He gets there, and that's the second out. On to first, and they get the double play. So it's two runs on five base hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. Nick Ahmed will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Chop foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2. Got him. And that's number 15 for the ball game. Time to bring you up to date on the numbers for our two starters. It's our starter comparison, and the hometown nine have had trouble generating much by way of hits, as you can see by the left side of your screen. And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Weak grounder back to the mound. Throw on to Gonzalez, and that's out number two.
Now batting, right fielder.
Yosmani Tomas will stand in as they're quickly down to their final four outs tonight. Chop foul right at home plate at strike one. The windup and the 0-1. Slider taken here. One ball, one strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a miss as he ran that in on him. A ball and two strikes. Coming up on the century mark in pitches now through the first 7 2/3. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
And a good job here of making him throw a lot of pitches. He probably doesn't have a whole lot.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. So 1-2-3 go the... Carl Crawford will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far.
Yeah, guys, he's got to be feeling a little bit like that dog that gets left out in the rain while the rest of the family's inside by the fire. I guess he's just not seeing what everyone else is.
Throw will not be in time as a perfect bunt there nets him a base runner to lead off the inning.
Chase Utley
digs in now after lining out in his last try.
And Matt, you know what? It's always a little frustrating when you square one up, you hit a solid live drive somewhere, and all you get to show for it is a nice little jog right back to the dugout. That can get in your head a little bit after a while.
And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
Well, I think this is going to wind up working pretty much like a sacrifice, but I don't think that's what he had in mind. This wasn't a show early and make sure you get it down kind of a bunt. He was trying to beat that one out, but a good throw is going to take care of him.
He's set. Now the pitch. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Covington sprinting after it, but he isn't going to get this one, and the pitcher's going to have himself extra bases. And the run is in to score from second.
Yeah, he gave it all he had out there in the outfield. Watch as he tries to close on this thing. He leaps as high as he can, but it's just out of his reach. Run's going to come in to score in what will turn out to be an RBI double.
Here's Howie Kendrick. Hit hard to short. Throw on to first, and Kendrick is gone. Two away now. Yasiel Puig steps in after hitting an RBI single his last time around.
And they take another single right here, too, no doubt. Runner in scoring position, so any ball into the outfield probably gets him home.
Skied into straightaway right. Moving under it, Tomas. And that retires the side. Paul Goldschmidt will begin their half of the ninth in a game that was decided long, long ago.
Yep, this is mop-up time out there right now. But hey, these at-bats still count against your batting average, so you can't go up there and just mail it in. You've got to see this through right to the end of the game.
Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. 1-1 pitch is a sinker taken for a strike. 1-2. Struck him out. Strikeout number 16 thus far as he's had a whale of a ball game. A.J. Pollard will stand in now hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot. 0-3 thus far. Adam Eaton is into the ballgame now as he'll take over out in left field.
Well, guys, it just hasn't been his day. You know, sometimes cleanup hitters are sort of smaller this change type for the hitters. Doctors. But, hey, now he's still got a chance to make an impact on this game right now.
Trace Thompson is into the ballgame as well as he takes over out in right.
Number 21, Trace Thompson.
Big curveball swung on and missed 0-1. You have to say they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Tap fouled at home plate. Bases are empty, one man out. Just hung in there on that one. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. On the ground to third. Turner's got it. Throw to first takes care of him, and now the Diamondbacks are down to their final out.
Up next for the Diamondbacks,
Paul Covington steps in and perhaps looking to drive another one out of the park just like he did in the second. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. On the ground up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field.
This is quickly becoming a situation where you'd like your guy to hit the complete game, but
Once you get into that 115, 120 range, you have to be concerned.
Sinker, one ball, one strike. And this is swung on and missed, so the Diamondbacks are down to their final strike now. And he gets strike three called to end it here, and with that, this one is over.
Well, we talked about how they needed a good outing out of this guy, and he gave them that and even more, finishing off the complete game victory.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. And guys, a Dodger victory may not have been possible here without the start turned in by this man, Clayton Kershaw. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, just the one run allowed, but anytime you can give your bullpen a day off, it does nothing but help your club in the long run.
Hi, I'm Justin Allegri, and this is your Wednesday edition of Inside the Show.
Starting in the National League West, Clayton Kershaw
earned the win while punching out 17 batters, leading the Dodgers over the Diamondbacks 10-1. He is currently in the top five in the NL in wins. Nathan Eovaldi got his... As the Angels got the win over Minnesota, 4-3. The A's had 12 hits as a team, as they were winners over the visiting Rangers, 8-1.
Thanks for joining me. That's all for today. Same place, same time tomorrow. Enjoy the games.